So far in the brewing process, we've gone through malting, kilning, mashing, lautering, boiling, and hopping. We now have the perfect environment for the next step, fermentation. Fermentation is going to be converting the malt-rich wort into beer. The organism that's going to do this for us is yeast. We have two main varieties of yeast. The ale yeast, Saccharomyces cerevisiae, are a top-fermenting yeast. In lagering, we have Saccharomyces pastoranus, a bottom-fermenting yeast. Once we're done with the boil, we need to cool the wort down to the proper temperature for our yeast. Ale yeast usually runs in the 65 to 75 Fahrenheit range, where lager yeast is much colder in the 45 to 55 Fahrenheit range. One of the reasons that lager yeast weren't overly popular or even possible until modern refrigeration. We have the perfect environment. In fact, all the processes up to this point has been getting that wort ready for the yeast. We have amino acids from the proteins, we have some lipids from the original grain, and we have lots and lots and lots of sugar. The first thing we want our yeast to do is to multiply. They've got a lot of work to do. We've got lots of sugar that we want to convert into ethanol, so we want them to multiply. The first thing the yeast is going to do is use the oxygen that is still in the wort and go through normal aerobic respiration. It's going to go from glycolysis to create pyruvate, and then the pyruvate will go into the Krebs cycle. This process creates CO2. The CO2 will then go into our vessel, and as long as we've sealed off the vessel so no oxygen can get back into the vessel, we're actually depleting all of the oxygen. Once we've gone from aerobic to anaerobic conditions, we kick in anaerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration is where we want our yeast to be, because that's when we start taking the pyruvate and turning it into ethanol. This ethanol is the target. The other thing about fermentation is there actually is two places where we want fermentation to occur. The first fermentation, creating ethanol, is usually called the primary fermentation. It is the bulk of the fermentation we want going on. The second fermentation is there to create our carbonation. So the focus of the second one is not necessarily creation of ethanol, but the creation of carbon dioxide. This carbonates our solution. The nice thing about fermentation is once we're done, we're left with a high alcohol content beverage that has CO2 in it. The nice thing about having CO2 in it is not only is it more enjoyable to consume, it also means that this beverage is going to last a little longer because the main component that's going to destroy flavor in the beer is actually air. So therefore, having the CO2 there as a byproduct of fermentation is essential to the shelf life of beer. At this point, we've completed our fermentation. We have beer. We still have a couple of other steps to get to the beer that you're used to, finishing and packaging. But at this point, we have converted barley into malt, malt into a wort, and the wort into beer with fermentation.